As a Vietnam Marine, I'm concerned about this number 13 here. If it's worded like I saw the young lady in the back showed me the resolution, I can live with that. But my question is, what's the purpose of the resolution? Is it going to be just in the county record, or is someone planning on sending it somewhere else? Is there going to be an add-ons and amendments? I don't want somebody to start lobbying their point of view. I'm a Vietnam Marine, and I believe in the Second Amendment. And that's it. If you're going to send that resolution somewhere else, since you guys have the right to amend it or put your personal opinion onto it, I think it's wrong. If that's all that's going to be done, I can live with that. But is that the purpose of the resolution? Is to be put in the minutes and that's it? Or is someone going to try to send it down to the wonderful governor and all that kind of stuff? If you do and you add on, I think it's, what's the word I'm looking for? I'm going to be diplomatic. I ain't going to be like that guy that walked out.
Overreaching, maybe?
Excuse me?
Kind of overreaching, is that what you mean? Trying too hard?
I believe in what you wrote. I like what you said. But if you gentlemen are going to use that as a tool to add on or amend and send it somewhere else and imply not what the resolution originally said, I think it's wrong. That's what I'm concerned about. What's the purpose of the resolution? Where's it going? Is it going to be just here in this house, in this minute? Is it a public record? Or are you using it as a tool to send somewhere else? And then you're going to put your personal opinions in. To me, that is dead wrong if you're going to do that.
Commissioner Robertson, you may want to speak to this first.
I'll be happy to, since I'm the one brought this forward through the administrator. I was asked by a lot of citizens to do similar to what Santa Rosa County has done. And our resolutions can be sent anywhere we decide to send them. We don't change them. Once we vote on them, they're sent just like they're written. And they can be sent. We can send them to the President of the United States if we want to. There's no point in having a resolution if you're not going to let the people out there that are voting on things like Second Amendment and all that, why even pass a resolution? No, it's not just for the people in this house or in this room. But the resolution that I would like to get passed whenever y'all time for me to make the motion is simply to state, like we did in 1994 when Commissioner Lee brought a motion very similar, and I had a lot of citizens ask me to do the same, simply states that we as five county commissioners, if they vote on it, everybody has a prerogative to vote their conscience. If it gets three votes, it's going to pass. And it simply says, and I won't read it all, that we want our Second Amendment rights protected. We don't want anything tampering with our constitutional right to bear arms. And we're going to take this resolution and send it wherever we please.
Okay, Chairperson.
But we're not going to change it.
Chairperson.
Yes, sir.
What he just said, I can live with. But if he adds on and he puts his personal opinion in there and he tries to say something that resolution doesn't say, he's wrong. That's not what the resolution says. I'm saying, if he sends it and he just made a comment, he was going to send it to the president. That's the way I understood it. That's fine and dandy, but that's all you send. You don't add your little 20 cents about what you believe, what with magazine sizes and all that stuff. That's what I'm concerned about.
Hey, let me say one thing as a member of the NRA.
How many years did you spend in the military, sir?
Sir, I've never spent a year in the
military. Yeah, that's what my point is. Go ahead with your NRA propaganda.
The Constitution protects my right to bear arms. It didn't say anything about I had to serve in the military to be under the Constitution.
Let me finish.
All I'm saying is, if I personally want to send this resolution anywhere, and this is public records, anybody in this audience can come down and demand this resolution, can't they? Public record. They can send it anywhere they want to. All it is declaring and proclaiming that this five-member board, 3-2 or 5-0, pass this resolution. Anybody can come down and ask for a copy of it. They can send it anywhere, and they can put their 2 cents in along with it as their personal opinion. You don't own all of the recommendations and opinions around here.
Okay, Mr. Nitz. Let's just one second.
Let me get personal back.
No.
The resolution is not what you
order,
say,
please.
Sir.
Order, please.
You tell
order,
me
please.
Not...
Please.
Okay. I want you to show me your respect.
here's how we're gonna respect you. Would someone please give him a copy of the resolution?
I already read it, sir. I read it.
Okay.
I have no
then
problem.
Then he has a right to his opinion, just as you do. He can
yeah,
talk
but not about, under the skies. It's
no,
the resolution.
No, Nims,
just in his opinion.
Nims,
don't
making,
use that.
I hear you loud and clear, but you're not. And he's entitled to his opinion, and I'm not going to deny that. And he can use it anywhere he
but
wants.
But you're acting like I'm not. I don't have my right.
You have your right to make your point, and you did. The resolution has four corners to the document, and what's going out of this dais, these chambers, is the resolution. That's it. There's no cover letter with personal opinions on it or anything. It's just the resolution. It's a respect to your point. I'm saying that we're doing just what you're saying.
I understand that, but he goes sit there and he basically said he was going to do it or give it to someone else to go, and they're going to use that as a guise. That's nothing but NRA propaganda.
Well,
thank you, Mr. Tort. I appreciate a little more professionalism. I wish you'd have a chit chat with him, but I don't appreciate. You know, it's a two way street. He thinks it's one way. Thank you.
We have a lot of input here from the public, and it's welcomed by everybody. Commissioner Robinson is next, then Mr. Tewart.
Mr. Chairman, I did get a text that said we were off the air, so I don't know what may have happened to our show, but apparently it was so lively talking about dog poop that we had everybody watching. They wanted to know what was going on. But I did want to say the only thing that I'm voting on is what's in the resolution. And I took an oath to uphold the Constitution of the United States in this office, and I believe this is exactly the Constitution of the United States, and I'm planning to support it just as the resolution says.
Okay, now Mr. Tour, Mr. May thereafter, and then Ms. Castro from Public Information on the status of our broadcast.
Any request to send this anywhere would come through my office. And it goes out exactly as this board passed it tonight, for clarification. There's nobody going to amend this document unless it's done up here. And if it is sent anywhere, it'll be sent just exactly like this board passed it here tonight. Just want to make that clear.
Thank you, Mr. Tewart. Mr. May.
And the purpose of this resolution is what, Mr. Administrator?
Hello? Actually, I work for every one of you, and every one of you come to me with requests to have agenda items. This was Commissioner Robertson's request for me to place this on the agenda tonight, and I think that's more of a question from Commissioner Robertson. I think he's pretty well explained it, but it wasn't my request. It was Commissioner Robertson's.
Okay, Mr. May, and Mr. Robertson.
I'll let Commissioner Robertson speak for himself, because I spent about 3 hours last night talking about the national gun debate in Tallahassee last evening with some state legislators, and federal law supersedes local law. And so I have a little reservations of why we're even getting involved in pushing this resolution. I'll tell you an experience that I had, and I'll just lay it here with Coach Nims. At one of our community centers, a gun fell out of a citizen's pocket a couple of weeks ago, and the police officers were called, but because he had a concealed weapon permit, he had a gun inside the gym, he was allowed to keep that gun, and that sets a bad precedent for us locally. And I think that right now, this is a hot topic. A lot of people are being shot, a lot of gun problems in Escambia County. When we know that there are guns sold at the Wedgwood Community Center, AK rifles, I don't think that this is a debate that we need to be involved in locally. Thanks.
Thank you, sir. Next speaker, Mr. Robertson.
This don't say a thing about assault weapons and all of that. All we're talking about is the right to bear arms under the Constitution. I have a concealed weapon permit, and most of the time when you see me, I'll have a gun in my pocket.
I have a concealed weapon permit as well.
So all I'm saying is guns don't kill people.
People kill people.
I know you've heard all this. Let me finish. And it's ludicrous, in my opinion, to say that just because we're having a lot of gun violence, we need to amend our Constitution. We're not talking about amending some county ordinance. We're talking about the Constitution of the United States of America. And I want to make a recommendation that we approve this, so I'll move the motion.
I see Mr. And a second from Mr. Robinson. Mr. Tewart, final word.
Actually, all I was going to ask Allison, don't we have a rule in our county buildings that you could not bring a firearm on any county property? I thought we did.
You actually no longer have the authority to regulate firearms. This building is considered a courthouse, and so even under a concealed weapons permit, you're not allowed to bring a gun into.
Maybe that's where I got confused.
This building, but you do have some county facilities and some county buildings, and I think that's what Commissioner May is referring to, where you do not any longer have the authority to prohibit that, unless they qualify under the exemptions of the concealed weapons permit.
I didn't mean to hold a meeting up, but I knew you couldn't in this building, the one across the street, but I didn't know. I thought it was what the restaurant building.
And absolutely, to Commissioner Robertson, no disrespect, I do support the right to bear arms, but certainly no one can even bring a gun up to our chambers without going to a metal detector, and our most precious asset, children, people in a recreation center can take care of a firearm. I think that's ludicrous, and that's a national debate, so that's my position.
Well, just read the resolution. That's all it says.
Okay, but someone please call the commissioners. Call the question.
Call.
Please vote. Thank you. Passes four to one with one no vote, Mr. May.
Passes along political signs.
Okay, next speaker is Mr. Michael Lauer. Wait a minute. I thought, same item?
You just voted for it. Well,
I apologize, Mr. Lowry.
It's okay, Commissioner.
Go ahead and tell. We might get
by. Commissioner, you're getting the bus with a pistol. Commissioners, Mike Lowry, 364 Maribel Drive. It's on this topic. The vote's over. Sometimes I come to you as a union leader. Today I'm coming as a father and as a citizen. So I'm speaking to my commissioner. When I saw this resolution, knowing what's going nationally, what's going on, in December, those 20 little souls were taken from us. And I'm sorry, I'm starting to already choke up because this affected me. I have an 11-year-old daughter, a 6-year-old son, and a 2-year-old daughter that's going to be 3 soon. And I guess what really took me back, Commissioner Robertson is an amazing man, and I support him all the time. So please don't take this personal at all. But when I saw the resolution, it caused me, when I heard about it, I will be honest, I have not seen it. All I saw was a quote in Rick's blog saying it was to stop the restrictions. And that concerned me because of the national debate on this. What I will say to you, though, is I felt obligated today to come to this mic, not for any other reason, but these 3 beautiful children that mean more to me than anything in this world. And I have the most important thing in my life, which is to teach them some important things. And that one thing that stood out to me is when I was out last few days with the bus riders, and I've been advocating for them to talk about the gas tax down at the city council, some of them approached me and they said, did you hear about this gun rally that's occurring at Martin Luther King Plaza? Now, you have nothing to do with that. That's a city property there, and I understand that. But what bothered me the most is what Dr. King stood for, that there's going to be a gun rally this Saturday at that location. Dr. King was for nonviolence. Imagine what history would show right now if his movement wasn't nonviolence. Dr. King is the example that I'm going to tell my kids about when it comes to I am an example of what I want you to know, which I don't share with people very often. But I served in the United States Army. I was in the 101st Airborne Division. Yeah, I was what they call a dope on a rope. I rappelled out of a helicopter, perfectly good helicopter. I was an expert with the M16, and I was an expert with the M60 machine gun. And believe me, if someone were to call me up and said, let's go to the range and fire that M60, I'd go. But after seeing what happened in December for those children, it changed a lot of the ways I think, and I am a supporter of the Second Amendment. And my concern is that my county commission is how you're trying to portray this in this time when there's a national debate on this. What was the purpose of it? I didn't know. I wasn't sure where we were going with this. What I will advocate for today is what I see Commissioner May doing in Montclair, in places like that. When that came out in the paper, I grabbed it, went over to my 11-year-old daughter, my 6-year-old son didn't really understand, but my 11-year-old daughter, and I sat her down and said, look at that, let's read it together. I talked to her about what they're doing in Montclair and what they did that day. And I just approached Commissioner May earlier and said, please, I want to be involved with anything you do in any community because it's about our children. And I will just say that I hope this is not being used in any kind of way for the event that's occurring Saturday in front of Dr. King's memorial, this amendment. I hope it's not. That is what I'm afraid of. I would have really appreciated that group, that organization, have the right to organize and to speak out. But I wish they had chosen another location, because I can tell you the folks that I represent and the folks that we transport in buses, many of them expressed to me over the last few days when the conversations came up that they were disappointed that a gun rally was being occurred, was happening at Dr. King's Plaza. But with that, I want to thank you. And some time was given to me by Ms. Bell. She actually had to leave, and she asked me to say this, that she actually went around the African-American community, some of the folks that she connected with, and they were very upset about what's happening at Martin Luther King Plaza. And of course, when the resolution came up, they were concerned of what the intent was behind it. So with that, I appreciate everything you do. Thank you.
Okay, hold on. In sequence, Mr. Robinson, then May. Mr. Robinson.
All right, let me address what was just stated there so we can make very clear of all this the best we can. This resolution was asked to be brought forward long before a rally was ever talked about. So there's no connection. That's where we get all these rumors and all this stuff going and all the bitterness and all. And if you read Rick's blog and you read the Independent News, even the News Journal, and think you can believe everything in there, you're wasting your time. But let me tell you, this has nothing to do with the rally. It is absolutely asked by people to me if I would consider, and I was happy to do it. I'm still happy that we're doing it. You hadn't read the resolution. You should have, because it simply states, as Commissioner Robinson said a minute ago, that it's not a gun rally that's going on over there, from what I was told. It was a Second Amendment rally. There's a whole lot of difference. There's a gun rally that maybe you're out just blatantly talking about, we ought to be able to bear all kind of arms and assault weapons and all that. That's one thing. The Second Amendment is what I understood the rally was about, protecting our Second Amendment. If you'll go to the Independent News, if you believe in it, read it, today's article. There's three or four pages that are full of every sheriff in this county, in Santa Rosa County. And of course, these are all Republicans. You'll read where that everybody in there, every sheriff, every congressman, every commissioner, and everybody else is attending rallies and are speaking or being quoted, that we're not going to stand back and be disarmed in this country. Now, you talk about this is a national debate. That's the problem. We sit back and let national do everything, and we don't defend ourselves. This amendment and this Constitution affects me. It's not just national. And this, all it does, it says, and I'm going to read the one thing that it says right here that Commissioner Robertson alluded to, that the Escambia County Board of County Commissioners hereby affirms its commitment to the oath of office taken by each commissioner and to the constitutions of the state of Florida and the United States of America, including its commitment to the Second Amendment. That's all this is about. It was asked to be brought forward long before the rally. Now, the location of the rally is probably awful. I had no idea when I said I would speak at that rally that where it was going to be. I had no idea, and I'm still going to speak. But I can tell you it has nothing to do with the rally, and it wasn't coordinated at the same time. But those 20-something little souls that died up there, there's not a person on this board that wasn't just as touched as everybody else. But I can tell you my opinion, if there had been a couple of deputies in there with arms that could protect those little children, it probably wouldn't have happened. People that want to do harm are going to get guns. It's us that want to defend ourselves against those people that need to have our arms.
Okay. Commissioners, I just thank you, Mr. Robertson, and I'm just be wary of the time. I've been accused of running long, so I would ask you all to look at your watches. Commissioner Robinson, please.
Mike, and I certainly, you know, I appreciate you as a valuable citizen out in Maribel, and not as anything we end up dealing with here, just as citizen to citizen. I very much appreciate, you know, you coming up here, and you know, we both have children about the same age. My issue is I have to constitutionally vote on what comes before me and read it. And if I read this, it says, it talks about the Second Amendment and what it says, and it says again that I'm, in my position as board, uphold the Constitution. I appreciate what Commissioner May's position in looking at some of the things, but my whole goal was not to politicize this. It was only simply to look at what was in front of me. And I could not, in good conscience, say anything one way or the other. I've taken the oath to uphold the Constitution of the United States, and that's what it says here before me, and that includes the Second Amendment. So that, you know, my vote is by no means trying to get caught up in the national debate one way or the other of that issue, but to do what is here, and I do believe there is a part of that that is the Second Amendment is there for reasons. There are a variety of different reasons. You can argue one way different, but I didn't look at that when I'm voting. What I'm voting on is asked on a resolution which states recitals and what it says, and based on my oath of office, I support the Constitution of the United States, and that includes the Second Amendment.
Commissioner Lumine.
Look, let's be clear. Democrats take the same oath as Republicans, and I apologize for making Republicans emotional on this stage, but this gun issue is an emotional issue, and I certainly support the Second Amendment. And I was just saying the culture and what we present and for our community, and we know we do have a gun problem, and right now I thought this was a very bad time to bring it up, and it's certainly insensitive to have any association with anything on the Mall of Martin Luther King as it relates to guns and shootings. I certainly support it. I could support it at the courthouse. I could support it at the dog park on the beach, but I certainly can't support it at the MLK bus. Thanks so much.
Commissioner, since this has already been voted on,
yeah, I know what we're talking about.
Let me please move forward. Mr. Tour, please.
Commissioners, I'm asking you to vote on the balance of the 14 items on technical public service consent agenda.